Alright, so I'm pretty sure since the last time you saw the multirotor Mania 180, it had a Flip 32 F3 on it, and something happened to that flight controller. See if I can find it here. I don't know where I put it, but I ripped the pads off of the buzzer pads. They came off so easy. Like, every single hole on the Flip 32 F3 has through holes except for the buzzer pads and the RSSI. So the buzzer pads, they came off very easily. Okay, but to me, that was kind of a blessing because I ended up getting the omnibus, which is the Flip 32 omnibus, and it's 10 times better than the Flip 32 F3. So I am actually happy that that thing broke. Well, it's not broken. I mean, it still worked without the buzzer, but I don't like flying a quad without a buzzer. So if I can't have a buzzer on the FC, then it's worthless to me. So I got the omnibus on here. You can see it's got the two little buttons. It's got the micro SD slot there. This is the best FC that I've ever used. It's just awesome. But then I ended up not liking that Yishin little CCD camera, mainly because I couldn't find a good lens for it. It came with like a 2.8, and I can't fly with that. I gotta have a little bit wider, at least a 2.5. So I tried a few different lenses, and every one that I tried, it just made everything blue. So I was like, screw it, I'm just gonna get a new camera. So I got a new camera. And I'll show you what it is. The aomway. This camera's been around for a while. I've always been checking it out and stuff, but I never bought one until now. And I think I'm gonna be pretty happy that I did. I don't care about CCD. I like CMOS just fine. This is a CMOS, but it does have a wide dynamic range as well. And for any of you that don't know about the Runcam Eagle is a CMOS. And I'm not sure about the Monster, the Fox Ear Monster. I think that's CCD, but that Eagle is CMOS and it's pretty badass. So can't talk shit about all CMOSes. But I heard good things about this one. And I've been wanting to try one out for months, so here it is. It was very well packaged, and it's as small as I thought it would be. It's tiny. It's kind of long, but that's fine, because it is going to sit inside the frame. Oh yeah, that's going to fit perfect. So I'm not sure if I'm going to use this one. Or it also comes with one. This one's a little bit different though. This one uses the rings to lock it in, I think. Let's check it out. Oh, that's a nice lens. I like that. It's 170 degree. Awesome. Now I'm not sure, but I think it has these holes over here. And I think you're supposed to like stick a pin or something in there to make it into, oh no, it is an NTSC, so they marked it red, the little rip box, they marked it red for NTSC. So I'm not sure what this is over here actually. I'm sure somebody out there does, but I don't think it'll pertain to me and what I'm gonna be doing, so Anyway, let me check out this. I was a little worried about the wiring too, because I got already got these wires sticking out here, ready to go. This is running to a 5-volt regulator. This camera is 3.6 to 5.5 volts. So not only do I have a step down 5-volt regulator here, but this regulator is soldered to a 12-volt regulator on the PDB. So I got two regulators going on here, so this should be the cleanest it could possibly be. But I'm kind of liking this, and it's going to match my quad, so let's see if it's going to work. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I'm going to stick this on there. Let me see how it goes, though. So probably got to take the lens off. So, let's see. I probably got to move this up. And then when I get into focus, I stick another ring on there. That's a really nice lens there. I'm hoping for good things on with this. I guess I don't need two rings. I don't know why I came with three rings. But yeah, this is gonna lock it in just fine. So it's gonna be upside down like this. Oh yeah, that's gonna work. Perfect. That's like a 45, so that's plenty. I only needed about right there. Alright. Yeah, this is looking pretty nice so far. I really like that lens. It looks really nice. It reminds me of a GoPro lens. Okay. So it's nice it comes with the screws and the nuts. These are always nice to have spares, I guess. So, I am so excited about this omnibus. I highly recommend it to anybody that hasn't tried one yet. I'm planning on swapping out all my quads to that flight controller. I know it's not that new, it's not the newest thing, but I swear, man, when I first flew it, I was, like, shocked. And I've flown other F3s. Obviously. I think it's that MPU 6000 that just makes it just awesome. I just noticed I was on rccrazed.com, awesome store by the way, the other day, and I noticed that they have spares of these diversity lemon satellites. They have spare antennas for $1.90. I thought that was pretty cool because I haven't seen any spares around at all anywhere since these came out. I haven't really been looking, but so I'm hoping that I can just cut this off right here and then solder these three to these three. It should work just fine. These aomways always come with these big old wires, and it's kind of cool because it's like insulated and the wires are all separated and everything, but it's not needed for my case. So let's see here. I think I'm gonna go through, well, I have to go through from the top. Come on. Now it's going to be sticking out a little bit, but that's fine. Actually, I could clip that off. Yeah, I'll probably clip that off up front there. Okay. Okay, so next step is I'm gonna see, they make a CCD one as well. I've never seen that one before. And a 1200 TVO. 3.8, 5.5, 2.1. Mole JST. I got the mole because they were out of the JST. The Molex. Alright, so I'm going to snap this off. Maybe I'll go in a little bit further just to see what it looks like. Pretty sure I've taken one of these apart before, but... And this is supposed to fit, I know it fits in a couple of Amway VTXs, which is just awesome. Even though it doesn't have the wires for the 5 volt out. Or wait, maybe that's what that is. Yeah, never mind. That's the 5 volt out and then the video, and then there's another section on the VTX that has a power and ground. I don't know why this plug's so big. Well, I guess actually there's the audio too. Okay, I don't want to rip those out, so. Gotta be gentle here. Okay, they stop right there, so I'm just going to have to cut it right there. Which is totally fine. Luckily, that I already have the wires already coming out here that are long enough. For some reason, the ground is much thicker than the other two wires. It's kind of weird. I've never seen that before. Okay. So, we'll set this off to the side. Got me some new helping hands. I saw these at Hobby Lobby. So I had to have them. Kind of tired of using that old board that I had with that little clamp on it. I'm going to be doing another video here later on, finishing up this brush build. Got the TX01. I'm immediately going to be removing that antenna and sticking this one on it. And I got that Eachine F3 board. Well, it came with a huge sticky piece, and it's 3M. That's different than the last stuff they sent. Let me check that out real quick. Yeah, actually it is different. It's a little bit harder, a little stiffer. There's nothing showing. I had it covered up. Yes, it was. It is. Plus, it's pointing down. Okay, so I got these are already tinned up, except for the video wire. So I'll just tin that one up and then get some heat shrink. Uh-oh, here comes Alyssa. Whoa, you're fast. You're pretty good on that thing. You need a new, bigger one, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so video. Here we go. No, Alyssa, you're not going to be taking this stuff. Oh boy. Okay, let's see if we can make this reach. Perfect. All right. So that's ready to be plugged in.
With your night-night, dear.
Not yet.
Sorry, I'll do night-night.
Oh, okay.
It's so, dear.
Okay, I'm on my way. Okay. In a minute. Whoa. This is why I haven't been doing any videos lately. No privacy. No time.
Don't do it!
Okay.
No apple juice!
No apple juice? Oh boy.
No.
Alright, I think that's gonna work out good.
Oh, come here!
Let's tighten it down and. I actually like this mount way better than that green one. Because it actually, it's just better. Alyssa, please turn it on. Fits in there real nice. Just perfect. Right in between those 30 amp ESCs. And that mount matches. Let me get this plugged in and see what it looks like. Another thing I noticed about this flight controller is that it doesn't care as much about a bent prop as other flight controllers, as any other flight controller that I've ever used. For example, I was flying this like yesterday, I think, and I crashed, bent a prop a little bit, and every single time with any other flight controller, whenever that happens, it'll make this weird off sound, and like you can just tell that you got a bent prop. It doesn't sound right, and that didn't happen with this one. It just sounded perfect with the bent prop. Come on. This is my first time really putting it together with all this LEDs and the everything. Make sure I'm not smashing anything. Looks good. That's as high as I can go, but that's plenty of tilt for me, especially with 170 degree. I could go like that and still see up here. Okay, I'm just gonna put like one or two screws in here. I swapped out all my screws with these ones that came with these DYS motors because I kept having problems with the inside stripping out, so I would end up to where I couldn't even take certain screws off at all, no matter what I did. And so I finally was able to get them all out, and I was like, I'm never letting this happen again, so I'm putting these on, and that way if it ever does strip out inside, I can still get a pair of pliers on the outside. So, that's good. I don't know if it's my cheap tools or what, but... Alright, that's good to go. And I'm so glad I got this camera. It looks way better, too, than that Yashin one. And it's in there really nice. And I haven't even, like, you know, dialed it in yet or nothing. Probably need to still focus it as well. But let's see what happens. Ooh. Look at that. It's almost completely focused, and I was like, just guessing. That looks pretty decent. That looks really decent. Dang. Dang, that's looking really good. Those props are looking really blue too. See if I can get it a little bit more in focus. A little bit out. Yep, that's about as good as it's gonna get. That's nice. I like it. I'm actually happy with it. I won't know for sure until I test it out in sunny and overcast days, but so far indoors here, the colors look really nice. Oh, look at that. Yeah, that looks excellent. I could probably get it even a little bit clearer switching the channels too, but that just looks really nice. Let's check out the dark. Yeah, it's a little bit brighter than it is. Let's see, really dark. So I don't think it's turned. No, it doesn't go black and white that I know of so far. Could be because of my LEDs though or something, I don't know. Not bad though. For a $24 camera? Yeah, this is excellent. Okay, so I'm done with this. Probably tighten it down a little bit more. Put the rest of the screws in. I don't really care about this up here very much. I might eventually take a razor and do something. But yeah, I'm very happy with this. It's tiny and light. Picture looks great. The lens looks awesome. This mount is perfect for this quad. See if I can tighten it up a little more. Yeah, that totally looks like a GoPro lens. Oh, come on. This one. It's pretty tight. It has a little bit of bounce, which is nice. I gotta check it out in flight. Make sure it's not gonna be no jello crap. But I don't think it's going to. Oh, yeah. That's in there really nice. God, that looks so much better. I gotta put a zip tie up here too. Alyssa, are you okay? Oh yeah, that's perfect. So yeah, that came out excellent. The colors look just so rich. It's awesome. All right, well, that's all I got.